is happening right now? This is not Los Angeles. Welcome back to our natural habitat, aka the Santa Monica Tesla Charger. We have a fun one today. And that's because today we're going to be checking out the top future mega legendary Pokemon that will hopefully one day, hopefully soon, come to Pokemon Go. It is my prediction that this year, 2022, will be the first year we see a mega legendary Pokemon released in Pokemon Go. So today, again, we're gonna go over the top big dogs. And also, while we're in Santa Monica, quickly, just wanna log, we're not gonna like walk around or like do like a crazy hunt. Also, it's just a bit dead here, but we could maybe get a shot. Okay, actually, we do have an Arlo here, which I'm freaking 1,000,000% down for. If you don't remember, at the end of April, we will be seeing a brand new legendary, a brand new mega Pokemon released in Pokemon Go. We don't know exactly which mega Pokemon it's going to be. It's a secret, it's a surprise. And obviously, I'm fingers crossed hoping for the first mega legendary to happen in the month of April. Please let me know in the comments, what mega legendary are you looking forward to most? And after watching today's video, let me know which one you're most excited about, because there's some cool ones. And before we rock into the mega legendary Pokemon, maybe we can rock a mega Shadow Shiny. Actually, Bagon, Salamence does have a mega version. So mega, I guess you have to purify it, but mega shiny Salamence one day, 100% with this Shundo. I want to start with probably my favorite mega legendary, hopefully coming one day to Pokemon Go, the one and only Mega Rayquaza. Mega Rayquaza is going to be a literal monster, possibly too OP for Pokemon Go. I don't know how they're gonna balance this thing in game, because this will be a dual type dragon and flying mega Pokemon, and it's going to max out at an absolutely insane 6,817 CP. Oh my God. It's also gonna have an attack stat of 389, a defense stat of 216, and a stamina stat of 233. Those are really good base stats. And with an attack stat of almost 400, this thing is ridiculous. I will say it is double weak to ice, so that's its one downfall. Let's talk about Mega Rayquaza in the Pokemon Go meta. Will it be good in Pokemon Go? Oh boy, will it. Starting off with Mega Rayquaza as a dragon type. So the current number one dragon type in Pokemon Go is actually Mega Charizard X, and Rayquaza is going to demolish it. I mean, blow it out of the water. Ice bucket challenge, Charizard's flame. Dunzo. And the reason is because Mega Rayquaza has nearly 2,500 more CP than Mega Charizard does, and its attack stat is over 100 higher than Charizard's. Rayquaza will be the number one dragon type Pokemon in Pokemon Go by an absolute long shot. The only thing that might contend with it a little bit will actually be Mega Salamence, which will hopefully come out soon too. But even still, Mega Salamence has 1,000 less CP than Rayquaza, and it has a lower attack stat. So Rayquaza is gonna destroy that thing too. When it comes to the dragons, Rayquaza is king. Now, this is a dual type Pokemon, so what about Mega Rayquaza as a flying type Pokemon? The current top flying type Pokemon actually include Mega Charizard Y and Mega Pidgeot. Mega Pokemon kind of run the leaderboards here for the top of certain typings just because they're megas, so it makes sense. It's like a battle of the megas. Okay, so Rayquaza as a flying type compared to the current meta. Mega Rayquaza is gonna have over 1,800 more CP than Mega Charizard Y, and it will have over 2,700 CP more than Mega Pidgeot. I think you know where this story is going. Mega Rayquaza also has just way higher base stats than both of those Pokemon as well. And again, really the only thing that's gonna compete with Mega Rayquaza as a flying type will be Mega Salamence, and it will still get just outclassed. Mega Rayquaza will be one of the best Pokemon in Pokemon Go, mainly because dragon types are kind of useful, and flying types are sort of useful, but it is going to be a DPS monster. Again, 6,800 CP, this thing will be, again, one of the best Pokemon in the game. And speaking of some of the best Pokemon in the game, the next Megas we're gonna talk about are actually really exciting because I think they're a lot closer to being released than any of the other ones because they have been sneak peeked several times by Pokemon Go in the past, and they're still not here. First though, I gotta get groceries because we gotta cook today. Boom! Groceries are in. Now I can meal prep. And now we can talk about the other Mega Pokemon coming, hopefully one day, to Pokemon Go. These ones are crazy. All right, let's get into it. The other Mega Pokemon, starting with Mega Mewtwo X. Mega Mewtwo X is super duper exciting because it was sneaky peeky teased in the 5th year anniversary poster for Pokemon Go. You can see Mega Mewtwo X up there, arms crossed, ready to freaking lay down some damage. And here we are approaching the 6th year of Pokemon Go, still no Mega Mewtwo X. So, I don't know, hopefully
freaking fingers crossed we see this soon. Well, this is a dual type fighting and psychic Pokemon, which makes it an absolute monster. Mega Mewtwo X is going to cap out at 6,138 CP with 375 attack stat, 202 defense, and then 214 stamina. That 375 is absurd. Okay, let's give it a little meta analysis. First, as a fighting type Pokemon, the current number one fighting type Pokemon in Pokemon Go is Mega Lopunny. Now, Mega Mewtwo X will have 1,800 more CP and nearly 100 more on the attack stat than Mega Lopunny. And when matching it up against all the other top fighting type Pokemon, I mean, it just freaking blows them away by a landslide, which will make Mega Mewtwo X the number one fighting type Pokemon in Pokemon Go. And since fighting types are honestly really, really helpful and very useful, Mega Mewtwo X will be one of the most useful Pokemon in the game as well. Now, as a psychic type Pokemon, comparing it against the number one psychic type that is currently in Pokemon Go, which is actually Shadow Mewtwo, funny enough, at 4,700 CP, Mega Mewtwo X has 1,400 more CP than Shadow Mewtwo and much better base stats, although obviously Shadow Mewtwo being a shadow does a lot of damage compared to normal Mewtwo, but compared to Mega Mewtwo X, I mean, like, what are you gonna do, you know? But the nice thing is that these two Pokemon can actually live in harmony because the psychic type attack boost from Mega Mewtwo X is gonna complement a Shadow Mewtwo very, very well in a raid. So that's just really cool that they could be homies. Mega Mewtwo X will easily be the number one fighting type and the number one psychic type in Pokemon Go until Mega Mewtwo Y. The reason why is because Mega Mewtwo Y is just, it's a pure psychic type at 6,343 CP. That is so big. And its base stats are absolutely absurd. It has a 388 attack stat, a 202 defense stat, and a 214 stamina stat. 388 attack with 6,300 CP. Ridiculous. Also very exciting about Mega Mewtwo Y is that it was teased, sneak peeked in the fourth year anniversary poster for Pokemon Go. This is like way back. This is almost 2 years ago. We were teased with Mega Mewtwo Y, which, man, give us the freaking Pokemon. I feel like Pokemon Go is still working through exactly how to balance these in the game just because they will be so powerful. But if I had to make a guess, out of all these Mega Legendary Pokemon, Mega Mewtwo Y is the one that I think we would see first, mainly because it was sneak peeked first. Now, bit of a meta analysis on this. Obviously, it is a pure psychic type Pokemon, and it really could just be explained as a better Mega Mewtwo X. Obviously, as we said, Mega Mewtwo X outclasses all of the top psychic type Pokemon by a landslide, and Mega Mewtwo Y should outclass Mega Mewtwo X. This should be the number one psychic type Pokemon in Pokemon Go. It will be a freaking savage. Next on the list is something also very exciting because I can't really talk about this too much, but some of its data has been found in Pokemon Go. Welcome Mega Latias. I don't really like Mega Latias or Latios that much just because they just look weird, you know? And I'm just not a big fan of their Pokemon in general, but these are pretty cool. Mega Latias is a dragon psychic type Pokemon. Very interesting dual typing there, with 5,428 max CP, which is just massive, and a 289 attack stat, 297 defense stat, that's important, and a 190 stamina stat. That 297 defense stat, that is not something that you see in a lot of Pokemon in Pokemon Go. That is a really high defense stat, which means it's going to be very, very tanky. Now, it does have a lot of weaknesses, but also a lot of resistances due to its dual typing. But again, that 297 defense stat is really gonna help it take a punch in battle. Okay, meta analysis. As a dragon type Pokemon, if you compare it to the current Pokemon Go dragon type Pokemon meta, I mean, this thing just outclasses all of them. It destroys them. But when you compare it to the famous Mega Rayquaza and even Mega Salamence, Mega Latias doesn't really stack up against those two. It will definitely be outclassed by the other bigger Mega Pokemon. But basically, if Mega Latias drops first before Rayquaza and Salamence, it will be the number one Dragon-type Pokemon in the game, which is, I mean, just kind of a flex to be. But again, once those bigger, stronger Megas come out, it will drop in the ranks to like third or fourth. So this thing will always pretty much be a top dragon type Pokemon. And then as a psychic type, it has pretty much the same situation as its dragon typing, except with psychic type, it's not gonna match up against Mewtwo. Does this make sense? If Mega Latios comes out before Mega Mewtwo, then it will be a top psychic type attacker, if not the number one psychic type attacker in Pokemon Go. But once Mega Mewtwo X and Y release, Mega Latias is gonna be a little bit irrelevant compared to those two when it comes to psychic type Pokemon. Now you can't have Latias without Latios. What about Mega Latios in Pokemon Go? This is another dragon and psychic type Pokemon. It is going to be 5,661 CP maxed out, which is absurd, with a 335 attack stat, massive, 241 defense stat, still high, and a 190 stamina stat. And looking at this thing kind of in the meta, it can basically be described as a better Mega Latios. So everything we said about Mega Latios pretty much is the same thing for Latios, except Latios is just a little bit better. It would be the best dragon type Pokemon in the game until Mega Rayquaza and Mega Salamence release. And it would also most likely be the best psychic type Pokemon in the game until the Mega Mewtwo come out. And finally on our list today is a mythical, so not technically a Mega Legendary, but it's definitely worth talking about, and it's still, you know, it's not a normal Pokemon, it's not a Legendary, it's a mythical. Mega Mythical, Mega Deoncé. Mega Deoncé will be a Fairy and Rock type Pokemon with a max of 4,913 CP, with a 342 attack stat, a 235 defense stat, and a 137 stamina stat. The biggest downside is that because of its dual typing, it will be double weak to steel, and there are a lot of good steel type Pokemon in Pokemon Go. But as a fairy type attacker, right now, currently in the Pokemon Go meta, the number one fairy type is actually Mega Altaria at 3,576 CP, which is pretty low. Mega Deoncé would outclass Mega Altaria by a lot, like talking 1,400 CP more than Altaria and way better base stats. Deoncé would then become pretty much the number one fairy type Pokemon in Pokemon Go, really until Mega Gardevoir releases. And then also too, there's the Ultra Beasts that we talked about in a previous video. I actually did not compare the Ultra Beasts to any of these Mega Legendaries. So some of these might even get outclassed by an Ultra Beast, a Generation 7 Ultra Beast. But for now, Mega Deoncé would be the best fairy until Mega Gardevoir came out. Now, as a rock type Pokemon, it kind of has the same story. Comparing it to the current meta, the current number one rock type is actually Mega Aerodactyl. This is at 4,655 CP, and it is a monster. Mega Aerodactyl is one of the most useful Pokemon in Pokemon Go currently because rock types are so valuable. Now, if Deoncé gets the right moves, it would definitely outclass Aerodactyl both in CP and in base stats, making Deoncé one of the most useful Pokemon in Pokemon Go. This is until Mega Tyranitar comes out and takes the crown as the king of rock types. We'll talk about Mega Tyranitar in a future video. That is one of my most sought after megas. I really hope we see that soon. And again, Deoncé is a mythical, it is not a legendary, so I would assume we'll probably see this mega way later in the game, like talking like next year or maybe even the year after. I would assume that the Mega Legendaries drop first and then we see Mega Mythical come out way late game Pokemon Go. And those are all of the amazing Mega Legendary Pokemon to be in Pokemon Go. These are going to be amazing when they drop and absolutely take over the meta. Let me know in the comments which one of these Megas are you most looking forward to. For me personally, again, probably that Mega Mewtwo Y. Wait, Cap, Mega Mewtwo Y is probably gonna release first. I'm definitely most excited for Mega Rayquaza because I think it's gonna be sick. Hope you enjoyed and I'll see you all in the next video.